Welcome to Technia TV. Hello, I am Dr. Sandeep Kumar, Faculty of Management. Today, I am delivering lecture on discriminant analysis. Discriminant analysis is a technique for analyzing data when the criteria or dependent variable is categorical and the predictor or independent variables are interval in nature. For example, the dependent variable may be the choice of a brand of personal computer and the independent variable may be ratings of attributes of personal computers on 7-point Likert scale. The objectives of discriminant analysis are as follows. First one, development of discriminant functions or linear combinations of the predictor or independent variables that best discriminate between the categories of the criteria or dependent variable. Second one, examinations of whether significant differences exist among the groups in terms of the predictor variables. Third one, determinations of which predictor variable contribute to most of the intergroup differences. Fourth one, classifications of cases to one of the groups based on the value of the predictor variables. Fifth one, evaluations of the accuracy of classification. Discriminant analysis techniques are described by the number of categories possessed by the criteria variable. When the criteria variable has two categories, the technique is known as two-group discriminant analysis. When three or more categories are involved, the technique is referred to as multiple discriminant analysis. The main distinction is that the two-group case, it is possible to derive only on discriminant function. But in multiple discriminant analysis, more than one function may be computed. Examples of discriminant analysis abound in marketing research. This technique can be used to answer questions such as the following. First one, in terms of demographic characteristics, how do customers who exhibit bank loyalty differ from those who do not? Second one, do heavy users, medium users and light users of soft drinks differ in terms of their consumptions of frozen foods? Third one, what psychographic characteristics help differentiate between price sensitive and non-price sensitive buyers of groceries? The fourth one, which is do market segments differ in their media consumption habits? The last one, what are the distinguishing characteristics of consumers who respond to direct mail solicitations? Now, I am explaining the relationship between discriminant analysis, ANOVA and regression analysis. The relationship between discriminant analysis, ANOVA and regression analysis are shown in table. We explain these relationship with an example in which the researcher is attempting to explain the amount of life insurance purchased in terms of age and income. All three procedures involve a single criteria or dependent variable and multiple predictor or independent variables. The nature of these variables differs, however. In analysis of variance and regression analysis, the dependent variable is metric or interval scale, here which is mentioned as amount of life insurance purchased in rupees, whereas in discriminant analysis it is categorical, that means amount of life insurance purchased classified as high, medium or low. The independent variables are categorical in the case of analysis of variance. Here, age and income are each classified as high, medium or low. But metric in the case of regression and discriminant analysis, which is mentioned here, age in years and income in rupees, that is both measured on a ratio scale. You will find this in the table. Two group discriminant analysis in which the dependent variable has only two categories is closely related to multiple regression analysis. In this case, multiple regression in which the dependent variable is coded as a 0 or 1 as dummy variable. Results in partial regression coefficient that are proportional to discriminant function's coefficient. Now, I am explaining the discriminant analysis model concept. The discriminant analysis model involves linear combinations of the following form: D equal to B0 plus B1 X1 plus B2 X2 plus B3 X3 plus Bk Xk, where D equal to discriminant score, B equal to discriminant coefficients or weights, and X equal to predictor or independent variable. The coefficients or weights B are estimated so that the groups differ as much as possible the value of the discriminant function. This occurs when the ratio of between group sum of squares to within group sum of squares for the discriminant score is at a maximum. Any other linear combinations of the predictor will result in a smaller ratio. This is the end of my lecture on discriminant analysis. Hope you will find it useful. Watch more lecture on research methodology or business research on Technia TV. So subscribe and watch Technia TV. Thanks a lot.